my water is done, I'm going to take my bouillon that I have right here, and I'm going to just use it per instructions, and I'm just going to add 1 cube for 2 cups of water, okay? But I want this fully dissolved, and the reason that is because if you just throw in the bouillon in the rice cooker without dissolving it in the water first, you're just going to have clumps of this bouillon. It's not going to be evenly dispersed, okay? So some of your rice will get seasoned, some of it will still be white, okay? And we want that pretty red color, okay? So I'm just going to let that sit for a little bit while our rice is toasting up. in the rice. And the rice is so hot, I don't want to spoil it. So, I am going to spoon this rice into the rice cooker. Something's always wrong with it. Like this cooks it perfect, I promise you, every time. So, what I'm gonna do, now that I got the hard part out of the way, I am just going to hit this button, this switch right here, on the cook, and here in a few minutes. It'll let me know when it switches to warm and I'll show you guys what it looks like. Make sure though that you just kind of stir it throughout the process in your rice cooker so it can pump it up. That's all. Now the rice is done. It switched to warm, and as soon as it switches to warm, I unplug it right away, because if you don't, it'll stick and all this other stuff. So, and I also forgot to tell you to mention that before you add your rice, make sure you add your liquid or you won't get an accurate measurement. So this is the rice after it's done cooking. That's how it looks. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to let that sit for about 10 minutes. And then I'm going to come back and I'm going to fluff it up. So Alexa, set timer for 10 minutes.
Starting now.
Over here, you can see I got the fork. And I'm about to start making my tortillas. I got all of them rolled out, covered with oil. So, and if you guys want to see how I make my tortillas or anything else, have any other requests, please let me know. Comment down below. Oh, and Mariah's the one that she wants me to sugar. You want to say something, everyone?
Hi! Make sure to like and subscribe to my page and Daddy's page.
So, we're gonna let that sit for 10 minutes and then we'll come back. Okay, so now that the rice is done, I've let it set for 10 minutes in the rice cooker and I transferred it to a bowl. You can see it still kind of gets that, I don't know if you can tell, it's a little brown. That's from the rice cooker, and it's sticking kind of a little bit to the bottom, but I like that part. So, I just chopped up some cilantro.
No, Mommy, open it!
I'm gonna do the cilantro. And we're just gonna mix up the cilantro. Ooh, this is hard to hold the camera, sorry guys. I'm just gonna mix up all the cilantro in there. You guys, this stuff is so good. It's made with lots of love. So that's it. Now I'll go back to finish making my homemade guacamole. And I'll have a canola, so I'm using my cast iron skillet. And I'll show you guys what everything looks like when it's done. Can you say goodnight?
Goodnight.
Okay guys, so here's the finished product of my meal. My homemade pork tortillas, and then I just rub my line. Onion, and you can't forget the hot sauce. So I hope you enjoyed my video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for watching.